I'm actually interested in microalgae because I've been born and raised by the sea. And seeing this huge biomass almost every day and raised some question about what we could do with it, seeing what we can already do, like humanity can do with terrestrial vegetables, what can we do with marine vegetables? My name is Benoit Queguineur, and I'm initially a marine biologist. I specialized in seaweed for the last 20 years and working in Algaia for the last 8 years. The inflammatory bowel disease affects a lot of people and a wide range of faces, starting at a very young age. We already have some indication from the partners, but also from the literature, that there are some benefits in macro and microalgae for inflammation. So behind me, you will find some seaweed, some red species there that are used in algae for IBD. And the idea behind it is to make an extract. So basically make a smoothie and separate the solid phase from the liquid phase and keeping the liquid that will be tested with different algae for IBD partners. We are mainly looking at the anti-inflammatory activity of our extract, but also looking at the antibacterial, probiotic and prebiotic effects of the extract, and also looking at the antioxidant activity of some of them. When we get the feedback that we have a positive hit with the seaweed, we will incorporate the extract into a food ingredient and produce some gummy bears that will provide a solution for younger patients affected with IBD. Delicious. There are many challenges, starting from the cultivation. Harvesting seaweed in the wild or microalgae in the wild and then bringing them to lab scale is already a challenge. But also to bring it to an industrial scale is another challenge because you don't use the same tools and equipment. So you have to adapt all those equipments and adapt the recipes. Algaia is an industrial partner that is responsible for scaling up the great work that is done at many different labs in the Algae for IBD project. For this, we have the semi-industrial facility that we have here in Saint-Lô in Algaia. And this facility allows you to get a more refined taste for the final cost of the production of your extracts and also your final products. However, there is still some regulation that also sets a limit on what can be done with algae and for the good, because we need to protect also the consumers. And every time we develop a new food product with new extracts, we also have to go through this novel food regulation. It's a fact that people are moving away from animal-based gelatin, for example, that were used in gummy bears before, and also a growing population that is more and more aware of environmental challenges that we face. So we have to be more vigilant on what we eat and what we consume. So, and I think algae is a good answer to many of those challenges.